How many exercises should you be doing per workout for an effective vertical jump workout to increase your vertical, jump higher, and dunk a basketball? I'm gonna teach you that in this video. Young visionary, and I don't know where I am. I'm running blindfolded, like I ain't got a plan. You either steady living life, or you afraid to die. But if you don't take that leap, how you know that you can't fly? So I'm just... Ladies and gentlemen, before we get started, make sure that you like this video. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel, click the bell so that you never miss another video, and comment jump down below if you want a free bodyweight vertical jump training program. Today's question is from HSM, who says, how much workouts should I do for each workout? I think he means how many exercises should I do for each workout. For weight training, I would do squats, deadlifts, split squats, lunges, and for plyometrics, I would do 5 workouts. Well, I'll tell you first of all, okay, this is how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna get the whiteboard and I'm gonna give you a few rules to follow about how many exercises you should do per workout. Let's go. All right, so here we go. Here are our rules to follow. Rules to follow when we're talking about how many exercises per workout. And this pretty much is, it applies to workouts across the board. It applies for bodybuilding workouts. It applies for vertical jump workouts. Strength workouts might take a little bit longer than normal, but I still think it should apply for strength workouts. This should apply across the board for all workouts. So rule number one is that for your vertical jump workout, you need to be hitting all of the muscles that lead to a higher vertical jump. So, number one, hit all of the muscles. Okay, hit all the muscles. Rule number two is that you need to properly progressive overload. So, I don't think it's a bad thing if a beginner does 8 exercises in a workout as long as they are pretty easy exercises. So I would start low, I would start with body weight, and then I would progressive overload 5 pounds per week through different exercises, but make sure that you are progressive overloading properly. So that's rule number two. Progressive overload properly. Okay, so rule number one, hit all the muscles. Rule number two, progressive overload properly. This is the main one, rule number three. And the last rule that you need to follow when talking about how many exercises you should hit per workout is a vertical jump training workout should never be 2 hours long. It should never be 1.5 hours long. Now, I'm not talking about your warm-up. I'm not talking about your core. I'm not talking about your mobility. I'm not talking about your stretching. I'm talking about the main vertical jump exercises that you are doing should really never take longer than 45 minutes. 1 hour max. 1 hour and 15 max if you are really going for it. But you need to prioritize intensity over volume. Okay, volume meaning how many exercises you do. If you do a bunch of exercises that aren't, you're not being intense about those exercises, you're not going to make gains. So shorter workouts that are more intense are better. So is what I like to follow is I do as many exercises as I can in 45 minutes. Okay, I have 45 minutes to do as much work as I can. As long as I hit all the muscles and I'm progressive overloading properly, I go intense instead of really long. So number three is intensity over volume. Okay, so the amount of exercise that you do is going to be different for a lot of people. I'm probably gonna do a little bit more exercises than most of you watching this video. So, but the main thing, as long as you hit all the muscles that contribute to a high vertical jump, you progressive overload properly, and you're being intense, if you're feeling really intense after 45 minutes and you're like, I wanna go for more plyometrics, then do 1 hour long. If you wanna go more than that, then do 1 hour and 15. But make sure that you properly warm up, make sure that you do your stretching afterwards, and make sure that you are being intense the entire time. And then the amount of exercises doesn't really matter if you are following these rules. And really quickly, because I know a lot of people are gonna be asking, what are all the muscles that we should be hitting? So before I end this video, let me talk about this. What are all the muscles that we should be hitting? You should be hitting, obviously, your quads, your hamstrings, your glutes, And for this, you can hit your glute maximus, sure, do some barbell hip thrusts, things like that, but I really want to see you hit your glute medius with like monster walks, half moons, lateral shuffles. So glutes, especially glute medius, okay? Calves are okay. If you leave your calves out, I'm not going to cry about it, okay? Everybody thinks calves are the best thing since sliced bread. I don't. I think they're important, but they're not as important as every other muscle group. They're really not. So calves, then I want to see you hit your lower back. And I want to see you hit your core. Okay? So these are the main muscles that I want you to hit during your workout. So for your quads, you could hit squats. For your hams, you said you hit deadlifts. That's fine. For your glute medius, I want to see some monster walks, some half moons like that. For your calves, do some ankle bounces or some pogo jumps. For your lower back, I want you to hit some hyperextensions or some reverse hyperextensions. For your core, do some crunches. Everybody knows how to do core. I got a bunch of core workouts. I'll link one down below. So other than this, as long as you're following these three rules, then you can progressive overload and add as many exercises as you want, as long as you can do them within 45 minutes to an hour and 15 minutes, being as intense as possible. That's it for this video. Like this video if you like it, subscribe to the channel, click the bell if you have not already, comment jump down below for a free jump program, comment your question down below if you want me to answer your question on a video just like this, and take action, because action is everything. Knowledge is not power, it is only potential power until you take action on what you know. Results come from taking action and actually doing it, not just thinking about it. I'll see you in the next video. Young visionary, and I don't know where I am. I'm running blindfolded, like I ain't got a plan. You either steady living life, or you afraid to die.